हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दी वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। दिस इज़ राजुल सुथार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ श्री स्वामीनारायण इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, बार्ड, गांधीनगर। प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट दी बाइनरी इनपुट एंड आउटपुट फाइल्स एज वेल एज फाइल इनपुट स्ट्रीम एंड आउटपुट स्ट्रीम। इनपुट स्ट्रीम इज यूज टू रीड द डेटा फ्रॉम डेटा सोर्स द जावा एप्लीकेशन यूजर, एंड इनपुट स्ट्रीम टू रीड द डेटा फ्रॉम सोर्स लाइक द फाइल एन एरे और अ डिवाइस। And previously we also discussed the output stream that is used for writing the data to destination. The Java application use output stream to write the data to file or array or particular device. In this session we will discuss about the file class and random access file as well as serialization, and we will discuss about the generic class and interface. So what do you mean by file class? Let we discuss one by one. Java file class represent the file and directory path name in abstract manner. This class is used to creation of a file and directories, file searching and file deletion, etc. This type of operation covered in file. We can create a file, create a directory like the folder, and we are searching the file or delete the file. These are the operation performed on the file. The file object represent the actual file or directory on the disk. Below given the list of the constructor to create a file object. Here the constructor like file in the bracket string path name, so it create a new file instance by converting the given path name string into an abstract path name. We can use the parameter or constructor like the file in the bracket string parent string child, so it create the new file instance from a parent path name string and child path name string. This is a string type, and we can also use the file URI. File URI is also a one constructor. Like if you work with the URI, an output file will be in the form of some URI, that is called URL. Here one example for a file demo. So this is the class of class name is a file demo, public static void main, string argument as file f1 is equal to new file. File demo.java is our file, so we create an instance system.out.println file name plus f1.getName. This method is used. We also require the path, so system.out.println path plus f1.getPath. System.out.println abs path means absolute path, so here f1.get absolute path method is used. System.out.println parent, so it represents the parent path, as well as System.out.println f1.exist, exist does not exist, available or not. So this is the conditional operator we can apply here. First check the condition. If the condition is true, then true statement will be executed, otherwise false statement will be executed. System.out.println f1.canWrite, we can write or it is a writable or not writable file. So by using this method you can check you can write the file on the file or you cannot write a file. System.out.println, can you read the particular files or it is not a readable. System.out.println is f1 is directory, this particular file is directory, it is a folder or not. So by using this way you can check. And System.out.println f1 is file, is normal file, it might be a name pipe. If folder is not available at there, so it may be a file. So by using this way you can check the particular file. System.out.println f1.absolute is absolute path or not. So this is the condition. Also use the conditional operator, or we can say that it is a ternary operator. System.out.println file last modified, when it will be modified, last updated. So by using this way you can check. System.out.println file size, So what is the length of file in byte will be represented. This is the method that applied for particular file, like public boolean is absolute. It checked the whether abstract path name is absolute, it returned a true if abstract path is absolute, otherwise it will be false. Second method is public string get absolute path, it returned the absolute path string of this abstract path name. Public boolean can read, so it will be checked. Test whether the application can read the particular file denoted by the abstract path name. It returned a true if only the specified abstract path name exists, otherwise it will be false. Public boolean can write. So by using this way, you can test whether the application can modify to the file denoted by the abstract path name. It returned true if any only with the file system can actually contain the file denoted by this abstract path name. The application is allowed to write particular files. We can write to the files, or this is the give the permission. Otherwise, it will be false if you can't write to the particular files. Public boolean exists. This method is required. This method is useful for test whether the file or directory denoted by the abstract path is exist or not. It returns true if and only if file or directory denoted by the abstract path name is available. You can use the public boolean is directory method. So it tests whether the file denoted by the abstract path name is directory. So it returns a true, otherwise it will be false. Boolean is file, so it checks the particular content is a file or not. Same way, this is a boolean condition, so it become a true and false. Then public long last methods. This method is useful and it returns the time that the file denoted by the abstract path name was last modified. Whenever you are working with the particular files and you are update at that moment, the time represent means it will be modified. Just an example, it modified with the 2 p.m. yesterday, so it will be represent the particular days and with the time when file was modified. So here file format is covered into HHMM and SS, as well as GMT time. This date will be covered, like January 1, 1970. Public long length, so it return the length of the file denoted by this abstract path name. Public boolean delete method, this delete the particular file or directory. Public string list, so it return the array of string name, the file directory in directory will be available. Serializable interface. What do you mean by serializable? Java serialization is a mechanism for converting the state of an object into the byte stream. Deserialization is the reverse process, where the byte stream is used to recreate the actual Java object in a memory. Serialization is used to save the state of object. Serialization is maker. Interface has a no data member and method. It is use mark Java class so that the object of this class may get the certain capability. The clonable means it become a copy of particular object. So it is a clonable, and remote are also marker interface. It must be implemented by the class whose object you want to persist, means if you want to permanent store the particular object, so it may be implemented by using the class. The string class and all the wrapper class implemented by java.io.serializable interface. This is a default interface. You make the object serializable, we should have to implement the java.io.serializable interface. So this is the figure. If 3 marks of question ask in GTU exam, so you must have to create a figure regarding to the serializable or serialization or deserialization. object to stream is called serialization, and stream to object, that is called deserialization, reverse process. Random access file, the Java provide the facility to read and write data into the random access file. This class is used to reading and writing to random access file. A random access file behave like the large array of byte. It use the java.io.randomaccess file. This class is used to perform this operation. Random access file use the cursor implemented to array that call the pointer. By moving the cursor, we do the write and read operation. If end of file is reached before the desired number of byte has been read, then EOF means end of file exception is thrown. It is type of IO exception. It is covered into the IO exception. This is the modified and method like void close. So this method, it close this random access file and release any stream resource associated with the stream file channel. So get channel method, it return the unique file channel object associated with this file. Integer read integer method, it read the 32 bit integer from a file. String, we can use the read UTF character, so it read the string from a particular file. Void seek method, so it is a long post. It set the file pointer offset, measure from beginning of the file at which the next read or write will be occurred. Some of the other method also covered like long length, or void write integer, void seek method to set the file pointer at particular position, and some of the method like read the particular character integer string read UTF. So it read the file from store in the string format. Let we discuss about the recursion, problem solving using recursion. What is a recursion? Recursion is a mechanism when method call itself. We all familiar. So recursion in the Java process in which method call itself continuously, same like in the C and C++. A method in a Java that call itself is called a recursive method. It make the code compact but complex to understand. Here the syntax like return type and method name, then body, code to be executed, method name. So calling same method inside the body, that is called recursion. It reduces the size of program, but sometimes it make a complex. While designing the code, we must care about the ending condition, otherwise it will go the infinitive loop. Some of the needs, like if we use the break the problem into the smaller subgroup, so we can use the recursion, or a smaller sub problem can be solved by solve some of the original problem, so we can use the recursion. Or we can merge the solution of sub problem such that it reflect the solution of our main problem, so we require the recursion. Here one example for recursion, we all familiar, the factorial program work like this, calling itself. So this is a useful example whenever 3 or 4 marks of question is covered. One of the method, recursive helper method that cover the method is called by another non-recursive method, that is known as a recursive helper method. And it also cover the tail recursion. So what do you mean by tail recursion? So tail recursion is a recursion when a recursive function call recursion at the end of instruction. Tail recursion is useful when algorithm call iteration and at last it will call recursive part. This mechanism is useful to avoid the stack overflow. this is used for avoiding the stack overflow error. Here large example, like example here covered, public class tail recursive demo, public static void main string argument as function 3, here public static void main function integer n, system.out.println n will be displayed if n greater than 0, so function n minus 1 will be called. This type of a example covered. In this example, before recursive happen, we doing the minus operation, like we are performing the function n minus 1. So this type of example we covered in the tail recursion, that is called tail call optimization. One difference covered for the iteration and recursion, like method of implementation. So iteration means implementing using the loop, and recursion function call itself. State, for the criteria of the state, iteration defined by the control variable its value, and recursion defined by the parameter value stored in the stack. If we consider the progression, so the value of control variable move towards the value in the condition while we are using the iteration. While in the recursion, the function state converts toward the base class. If criteria cover the termination, so in iteration, loop end when control variable's value satisfied the condition. While in recursion, recursion end when base class become a true. The code size, this parameter is used in iterative, so iterative code tend to be bigger in the size, but in the recursion it decreases the size of code. While no termination state, in iteration infinite loop use the CPU cycle, while in recursion infinite recursion may cause stack overflow error or might be crash the particular system. And we perform the execution, so in the iteration execution become a faster, while in a recursion execution is slower. So this is the difference. 4 marks of a question asked in GTU exam. What is a generic programming? The generic in the Java is similar to the template in a C++. The idea is to allow type integer, string, etc. User defined data types, to parameter, to method and class interface. The Java generic method and generic class enable the programmers to specify with a single method declaration a set of related methods, or with a single class declaration the set of related types respectively. The generic also provide the compile type safety that allow programmer to catch invalid types at compile time. Using the Java generic concept, we might write a generic method for sorting an array object, then invoke the generic method with integer array, double array, string array, and so on. So to sort the array element, this generic method is helpful. Same way, Java provide the facility to declare the generic class and generic method, which provide the useful mechanism to declare the method, class and interface suitable for similar type of elements. What is the need of generic? It save the programmer burden of creating separate method for handling data belong to the different data types. It allow the code reusability, and compact code can be created. Here we can define the class and interface by using generic. So this is the name of a class, public class test, public test, and public test without argument, with argument. So t value is one argument. and the first one public test that cover the value is equal to null. So this dot value is equal to value is retrieve the value by using dot operator. Public get value, it return the value, and public set value, so value is equal to new value. Private t value, this variable defined as a generic. If we declare the particular variable as a private, so this variable is called a generic variable. Some of the wildcard generic type, so in the generic code, question mark is known as a wildcard. As we means known as a type of a generic class, it use when unknown return type or parameter or local variable or a field is used. When we use the wildcard, it never use as type argument or for any generic method invocation. We cannot use the instantiate generic class and super type. What is a eraser? Restriction on generic. So generic provide type checking at the time of compilation. The Java compiler that applied the type erasure for following operation, like the if we work with the produce the bytecode and contain only the ordinary class interface and some method. So insert type cast if necessary to preserve type safety. Some of the generic class object cannot be create with the primitive data types, that is restriction, or we can say that disadvantage. Type parameter cannot be instantiated. Cast and instance cannot be used with the parameter type and cannot create array of parameter type. That is the restriction. It cannot instantiate a generic type with primitive data types. It cannot create an instance of a type parameter. It cannot declare the static field whose type are type parameter. It cannot use or instant of a operator with parameters. It cannot create an array of parameter type. It cannot create a catch or throw the object of parameter type. And each of the overloaded erase to same row type. These are the restriction on a generic types. Thank you for attending the session. Here unit 9 completed, binary IO and recursion as well as generic. We will discuss the next unit 10, that is a list stack queue and priority queue. Thank you. Please like and subscribe the channel.